Hi, I'm Diego, a product manager in Android.
And I'm Jay, a tech lead manager also in Android. We're going to show you how Android has solutions for seamless and secure login experiences across devices. Let's get started.
Every day, we are interacting with more and more devices. Phones, smartwatches, tablets, TVs, smart displays, and the list keeps growing. A typical household in the US had 25 connected devices in 2021, up from 11 in 2019. But setting up a new device is often time-consuming and frustrating. When we get a new device or tablet, we are eager to start using it right away. But first, we need to open apps and sign in, one by one, even if we are signed in and using those apps elsewhere. So today, we'll be talking about solutions to make this better. You will see how Blockstore enables a zero-touch setup where users don't need to go through a signing flow in new devices if they have previously signed into your app on an Android device, with none or minimal changes to your existing authentication infrastructure. We believe that most developers could benefit from integrating with Blockstore. Now, Blockstore won't solve how users create an account to get started with your app. So for developers looking to streamline their sign up and signing workflows, we will talk about how OneTap provides a unified experience that's integrated with a user's Google account. Finally, we'll show passkeys, our signing solution with advanced security, built using the FIDO standard that allows for passwordless, cross-platform signing experiences. Let's start with Blockstore. For a seamless cross-device signing experience, last year we launched Blockstore, a secure and simple API that allows apps to store and transfer tokens and other data across devices. This API enables zero-touch setup, which removes the need for users to go through the signing process altogether. Users can just launch your app and continue where they left off, reply back in a conversation, finish watching a movie, order food for dinner, or any of the great experiences that your app enables. Blockstore offers an encrypted storage solution, and Google takes care of verifying the user's identity by confirming that the device is signing with their Google account. The user experience is seamless. They will be already signed in when launching your app for the first time on the device, with no system consent dialogues or need to manage passwords, allowing users to focus on interacting with your app. And it's very easy to implement. You can integrate with it with fewer than 30 lines of code, and app developers are in control of the format of data that they store and the user experience. Blockstore supports device-to-device and cloud restore for phones and tablets. In the future, we'll provide the ability to restore across other form factors. So, for instance, it will be possible to automatically sign users into apps when setting up a Google TV with an Android phone. So what does a user journey look like with Blockstore? First, the user signs into your app on their device. Then, your app saves the user authentication token to Blockstore. The token is encrypted and stored locally. If the user has cloud backup enabled, your app can optionally store the token in the cloud. When the user has a new device, they can choose to restore apps under Blockstore data. Then, your app requests the Blockstore data, the token is decrypted and returned to your app, and your app can use it to authenticate the user. The user is then able to access your app without any login screens.
So, how can app developers integrate with Blockstore? Let me walk you through a sample implementation. I have created this app to order delicious gelato online. I don't want my users to have to log in again once they get a new phone, so I'm going to integrate with Blockstore to be able to re-authenticate them. To set up my project, I add a dependency to the Block Store API. Then, once a user logs in, I'll add code to store an authentication token that can be used to log in the user to my backend. I did it in less than 10 lines of code. I created a store by data instance on which I set my token, then store that data instance with a call to Block Store client stored data. I can optionally register calls back to know if the operation was successful. That's it for storing data. At this point, my token is encrypted and stored locally on my phone with Block Store, and it's only accessible by my app. Now, let's look at how I can retrieve the data when my app is open on a new device. I simply need to call retrieveBytes on the Block Store client, and if data is available, the success callback is invoked and passed the token I store on the other device. I can use that token to authenticate to my backend without the need to show a login page to the user. Note that in this example, the data I store with Block Store was transferred when the user set up their new device by restoring from their old device. I can also extend that support to accounts restored from a cloud backup. To do that, I need to specify that by setting the shoot backup to cloud property to true. It's false by default. When enabling backup to cloud, the dataset for the app is backed up on Google servers. It is end-to-end encrypted for phones running Android 8 or later and that have a screen lock set, PIN, pattern, or password, which means in that case, the data cannot be read by Google. You can check whether end-to-end encryption is available with the is end-to-end encryption available call and decide whether or not to only store data with cloud support when encryption is available.
To learn more about Block Store, read the developer documentation. We'd love for you to try it out and give us your feedback. Block Store provides a seamless experience for signing in across Android devices. But what if users don't have an account yet? Google makes it easier for users to create and sign in to existing accounts with OneTap. OneTap makes secure sign-up and signing simple. It provides a cohesive, cross-platform experience supporting several types of credentials. OneTap is available on web and Android, so users can seamlessly authenticate anywhere. Here's what it looks like. A user that is already signed into Google and opens your app for the first time can create an account with your app with a single tap. They can then also sign back into your app's account with just one tap. OneTap's simple user experience has doubled our partners' new user acquisition and conversion rates. To get into some of the details, being a part of signing with Google, OneTap is an interface that helps your app create a secure, token-based, passwordless account that's associated with a Google account. OneTap can eliminate the dependency on passwords, reducing the security risks associated with storing and maintaining them. But if a user does want to create an account with a password, they can still use OneTap to save their credentials and sync them into the Google Password Manager and use it with Android or Chrome autofill. OneTap is easy to implement and is part of our Google Identity Service library. You will find much more information about OneTap in the documentation.
Finally, we're excited to show you passkeys, which we believe will evolve the way people sign in so that they don't even have to think about passwords at all. It doesn't matter which device they're on. Signing in with passkeys is easy for the user while also being significantly more secure. And best of all, passkeys work across most devices and operating systems. Passkeys provide strong protection against phishing and hijacking attempts following data breaches, two of the biggest security threats that passwords fail to prevent. They're an important step toward a more secure and passwordless future. And because passkeys are based on FIDO standards, they work not only on Android and Chrome, but across popular platforms and browsers such as Microsoft Windows, Microsoft Edge, macOS, iOS, and Safari.
Using a password is like sharing a secret, and that secret can be stolen. fraudsters are very good at tricking people into accidentally sharing their passwords with the wrong websites. And like passwords, passkeys aren't easily leaked thanks to the use of public key cryptography. Passkeys created on Android are backtapped and synced with Android devices that are signed in to the same Google account, in the same way as passwords are backtapped to the password manager. That means your user's passkeys go with them when they replace their devices. To sign into apps on a new phone, all users need to do is unlock their phone. Let's see it in action. I want to check the balance in my account with TriBank on my phone. I open Chrome and go to their website to sign in. First, I enter my account name, my password, and then I click Sign In. The website detects that I'm using a platform that supports passkeys and offers the option to create a passkey for signing in. Once I accept, Android guides me through the process of creating a passkey for TriBank and stores the passkey safely in my Google account. Once I'm done viewing my balance, I sign out. The next time I go to TriBank, I don't need my username or password. I select the passkey option, select the passkey I want to use, touch the fingerprint sensor, and I'm instantly signed in. Because passkeys require both having the phone and knowing how to unlock it, they effectively provide two-factor authentication in a single step. My passkey will get me into my account on different devices and platforms, including those provided by Apple and Microsoft, because it's built on FIDO Alliance standards. I have to make several payments and prefer to use my laptop for this. So I open Chrome on my MacBook, go to TriBank, and choose Signing with Passkey. This is my first time using passkeys from my phone on my laptop, so my laptop first needs to connect with my phone to use the passkey. I open my camera on my phone, point at it at the QR code on my MacBook, select Signing with Passkey, and allow the two devices to connect to each other using Bluetooth. My available passkeys for these websites are now displayed on my phone, so I simply select the one I want to use, touch my fingerprint, and I'm instantly signed in to my TriBank account on my MacBook. And because my passkeys are stored safely in my Google account, I can easily fetch them to use with a new phone or laptop. When I get a new phone or laptop, I still have all my passkeys ready to use. We just saw a login on the web, but my passkey also makes it easy to sign into native apps too. When I download the new TriBank app from Google Play and open it on my phone, I can use the exact same passkey to sign in.
For a closer look at how you'll be able to create passkey experiences in your products, check out IG Kitamura's Google I/O session, A Path to a World Without Passwords. We expect to have this technology available for developers to start testing with later this year. Stay tuned and check developers.google.com/identity/FIDO for updates. To wrap up, we demonstrated how to provide a seamless, secure sign-in experience across Android devices using Block Store, OneTap, and passkeys. Block Store enables zero-touch sign-in experiences across devices if the user has already signed into your app on a previous Android device, and it can be done using your existing authentication infrastructure. For account creation and first-time sign-in on an Android device, OneTap provides a unified experience that's integrated with a Google account. Finally, we reviewed how passkeys unlock sign-in experiences with advanced security using authentication infrastructure that supports the FIDO standard. We hope that these APIs make it easier for you to provide a seamless and secure sign-up and sign-in experience for your users. Read the developer documentation and give us feedback. Thanks for listening and happy coding!